To my YouTube channel. If this is your first time visiting, thanks for dropping by. If not, welcome back. This is the first in a series of videos documenting the Cross Newfoundland ATV trip that eight friends and I did in August 2022. It was a 9-day trip where we had 2 travel days and 7 riding days. We had rooms on the ferry crossing both ways, which I highly recommend, and we also stayed at hotels and chalets along the T'Railway Provincial Park. We started our ATV riding from Argentia and finished in Port Aux Basques. We rode a total of 1,131 kilometers for an average of 162 kilometers per day. We hit the trails around 9:30 in the morning and finished around 5 to 6 in the evening. On our last day riding, the ferry wasn't leaving until 11:45 p.m. So we ended up spending 11 hours and 56 minutes riding. Our daily stops along the route were Clarenville, Gander, Riverfront Chalets, which is halfway between Grand Falls-Windsor and Badger, Deer Lake, Cornerbrook, Robinson's, and then on the last day, we were back on the ferry in Port Aux Basques. To say this is an awesome trip is a huge understatement. If it's on your bucket list, do a little research. There's tons of resources on the internet, including other YouTube channels and videos like this one. Highly recommend it. Put it at the top of your list. Do it. You won't regret it. At the end of this video, I'll share a link to my photography website where I've shared over 500 photos shot with an iPhone, GoPro, drone, and a digital SLR camera. It gives a good idea of some of the sites we saw and some of the places we visited. Lastly, if you haven't already, please like and subscribe to my channel. By subscribing, you will get updates when I post new content, the rest of this video series, and I also post weekly videos of rides that our ATV FUN crew do, mostly central Nova Scotia, but we are spreading out as time permits, and some of those rides are as epic as some of our Newfoundland riding. So hope you enjoy it. Thanks for visiting. Again, please like and subscribe. Okay, with that introduction out of the way, this first video documents day one from Argentia to Clarenville. This section literally runs through the country and doesn't pass through any communities other than goobies. Even then, you don't really see it because the trail is surrounded by trees and bush. Also, the eastern side of Newfoundland is relatively flat as compared to central and the west coast sections. For those reasons, the first day's riding isn't as spectacular as the following days. But that said, it was part of our trip. We did have fun. We had a couple of mud holes that we hit and a couple other little sights and stuff that we saw along the way. And it was a great day overall, so I hope you enjoy it. Thanks.
That was just for here.
Okay. Thank you. Appreciate it.
a side-by-side coming back there too, so. How you guys doing? Nice, not bad a day at all. We'll take it. How you doing? Great day? You obviously didn't get the memo.
What's that?
Say so you didn't get the memo.
What?
Yeah. It's about the same back that way. Not a big lot of water. Enough to keep the dust down, so.
Do it.
That's all good.
I can get
wet. Have fun. Beautiful spot, man. Wow. Not that I'm surprised, being from Newfoundland and all, but hey. There's like 5-10 back there. Guys, what are you doing? Thank you. How you getting on? Coolio. Bikes coming, bikes going. Up the hill. There's a bunch more bikes coming there. There's probably about 8 or 9. There was about a dozen there all together. Some went left. I'm not sure how many. So, just a heads up. That's a great spot. Thank you. This is a little route off the trail, across the Trans-Canada Highway to Megan's Restaurant and Gas Place. Haven't been there in a lot of years, so I'm assuming it's still over there. We shall see. Back there. Oh, I just talked right there. Where are you going? Okay, I guess you're going back. Oh, awesome. Do. Little Brook.